What?
Ramon Bautista. I'm a DJ for the Blue Rats, and I teach at the UP Film Institute. I teach film. Yeah. Aside from that, I'm a commercial model.
Wow.
All around good looking guy.
So, sir, what was your childhood like? Like, how was it like growing up and stuff? Your family?
Yeah, I grew up in a normal neighborhood, in a normal family. Everything was pretty boring. I had dreams of becoming an astronaut, but unfortunately, the Philippines did not have a spaceship. So, I downgraded my dream to becoming a pilot. And then I found out that I was afraid of heights. Yeah, here I am, just here.
Did you always want to be like a celebrity slash teacher?
No. When I was growing up, I had very low self-esteem. I was very shy boy, and I never talked to people because I was going to make a mistake all the time if I opened my mouth. So until now, it still happens. But because of my good looks, I think it's my destiny to become really famous, like an action star.
Did you like idolize anyone in particular?
Yeah.
Like who?
Yeah. A lot of people. When I was growing up, I idolized Billy Joel Crawford. Who else? Luis Manzano and Lou Diamond Phillips. Do you know me?
No. Let's pretend that we...
You are young.
So, sir, how long did you study and what did you take out?
You're there. You're very small. But I studied high school. After that, I took up film here in the University of the Philippines. But before going into film, I used to study architecture. Because as a high school boy, I like drawing at the back of my notebook whenever the teacher got boring. And I made like really funny comics, and I thought, hey, the author of Pugad Baboy, you know this guy, Paul Medina Jr., he's an architect. So I figured I'd take up architecture so I can do some comics. But when I was in the College of Architecture, I found out it had nothing to do with making comics. So yeah. Then I shifted to film after watching some film festivals. And in that film festival in the UP Film Institute, I saw many, many ugly movies. I told myself, hey, I can make some of that. And yeah, after shifting to the UP Film Institute, I really made ugly films too. Yeah. After that, I started teaching here, and they forced me to take up some graduate studies. Now, I have master's.
When you shifted to film, would you want to be like a director or the actor?
A director or an actor?
Yeah, which of the two?
I wanted to be a cinematographer, a guy who controlled the lights and the camera. The problem was, I found out that I was a colorblind guy. So Yeah.
Really?
Seriously? To make, yeah. No, no, I'm not really colorblind. I'm just color stupid. I don't know brown from red, you know. Because my Crayola, when I was growing up, only had 8 colors. I didn't learn the colors beyond that. And then I made films already and became an animator, or sort of an animator. Made cartoons, and they won many, many awards here and abroad. Oh, I played very famous. I'm very, very good.
So, after studying, your first job was
in? After studying, well, during studying, I used to edit videos for my classmates. I even did their projects for them, and they made me, especially the basketball players, because they're in the varsity. They're either too busy or, you know.
At least,
yeah. They paid me many, many money, lots of money, to make their projects for them. Yeah, after graduating, I became a director, a writer, and a producer for this small up and coming UHF TV station called UNTV. UNTV before the dating Daan bought it. Yeah, and then we made shows like Strange Brew, Manic Pop Thrill, and all those things. Yeah.
So how did you end up being what you are now? As a
me? That's a great guy. I was born like this.
As a famous TV personality or professor.
Yeah. I had this friend, his name is Ari Rivera, back in college. We were classmates, and it's like during those days, we didn't have actors because we were both low self-esteem. And we are the only friends there in our class. So, in finding actors, we were having a hard time. So he asked me to act in his films. And I asked him to act in my films. So it's like 69. Yeah?
Yes.
You're above 18, right? All of you?
Yes.
No. No? Okay, forget the last thing. It's not Bastos anyway. But you get the point, right?
Yeah.
Well, anyway, yeah. He acted in my films, I acted in his. And then he became the director of Strange Brew and this show. It's a show that became popular in this on TV. And then I was a writer there. He can't find any extras to do the silly stuff. So he forced me to doing it, but I was very shy. But because of peer pressure, I said yes. And then after that, I had bigger roles. Like for example, the first role I had to play a doctor, and then the next role was more challenging. Was a sirena, sirena, mermaid, then a tambrasa, then a tubero, then yeah.
The Diwata.
The Diwata, there you go. Yeah, you seen that?
I watched.
Did you like it? Did you like
yes.
it? Did it?
I like the Bumapai episode.
It did not, that show did not refer to any drugs. It's a very wholesome show. Yeah, and after that, the same director, Ari Rivera, he starred me in this MTV interstitial called the Dan Michael series, where I play a magician. And then the Ramon Bautista show, and then after that, the rest was history, you know, because of my good looks. The big companies saw me and put me in commercials. Lots of commercials.